Live It Like Lisa here. First of all, I'm going to start by saying I have just got my Invisalign in. I've got two rubber bands on either side. So if I have a slight lisp or a major lisp, to me it sounds pretty ridiculous. And if you can see something in my mouth, that's all it is. So yeah, more on that in another video. But today I am super excited to join my little collab family here on YouTube to bring you guys a Christmas cushion DIY. So again, I'm joining with, and I'm going to do this in alphabetical order so I don't forget everyone, because we've got quite a nice little group together at the moment. So we have Shell from Shell's Glam Home, Claire from Claire's Crafty Corner, Tony from Crafty Decor by Tony, Mike from Mike's Life, that's with a Y, don't get it twisted, and Sook from Terrariums and Craft. So I'll leave a link to all of their channels down below. We're going to be creating a playlist for you guys. So if you want to check out everyone's video, it's going to be all there in one place. But yeah, we are creating a Christmas cushion DIY. I am pretty much doing a no sew, no glue, no Cricut machine or stencil template in any way. They are pretty much going to be the easiest cushions you will ever make. And apart from doing a little bit of artistic work at the end, because you'll see all the ideas I had didn't quite work out, so I had to freehand it all. I'm really happy with the way they've turned out. So enough yapping from me. Let's get straight into the video.
Okay, so to make our Farmhouse Christmas pillows, this is literally all you're gonna need. I have some drop cloth. This is a whole sheet of drop cloth. Obviously, I'm not gonna need that much. I'm only gonna be making two pillows. You're gonna need a stencil of what you wanna put on your pillow. You're gonna need hopefully just one red Sharpie. I'm just not sure how great these Sharpies are and how long they're gonna last. So I've just got all the Sharpies, all the red Sharpies that I own. You're gonna need a pair of scissors. And this is just a pillow slip that I am going to use as my sizing for my drop cloth. And that is it. Okay, so first what you want to do is you stretch your fabric out. Now, what you want to do is we want to make the cut leaving about a 6 centimeter border all the way around, and cut two pieces out of your material. So we're gonna do that now. And it doesn't have to be super precise, like really, it's fine. Okay, so you want four pieces this size, because I'm making two pillows, so we need two for each pillow. Okay, so we're working on the first pillow. So I've got my two sheets of drop cloth on top of each other. Now, I'm going to lay this one on top because we're going to use this as a guide and get it roughly in the middle. Now, what we're going to do, we're going to cut off each of the corners first. Okay, so we've done all our corners like that. Now what you're going to do is we're going to cut some strips all along here. Now you can measure it if you want, or you can just eyeball it. But I reckon roughly about, say, 3 centimeter strips. Just make sure you're cutting both pieces as well. Continue to do that on all sides. And we'll come back when we're done. Okay, so now that you've cut all your strips, all we're going to do is just tie them together. So you get the two and just tie them in a knot. You can do two knots if you want, or just one is fine. So this is basically going to join the cushion together.
Thank you.
Okay, so we're just going to leave this side open for now because clearly we still have to put our cushion insert in. But what I'm going to do now is we're going to do the stencil. Now, the only reason I didn't do the stencil before tying it is because all these aren't completely even. I wanted to make sure that it's going to be in the middle once I've actually done the cushion. All right, so we're going to lay it flat. We're going to do a couple of stripes down each side, and we're going to have this in the middle. So I'm just going to cut this out. Okay, so that's pretty much where I want that to go. Now, what I want to do first is create some stripes down here. So just grab my ruler. So for the words, I've tried a few methods and none seem to be working. I don't have a Cricut, so I can't make a stencil. So I'm just going to basically eyeball it, to be honest. We'll hope for the best. So I'm just going to stick it down. Right, so wow, that was a bit of an effort. Let's stuff it now, and my catchphrase of this year, let's stuff it. So the second pillow we're going to make is going to be exactly the same, made exactly the same way, but instead of writing words on it, I'm just going to do the ticking stripe down the middle, like a bigger pattern. And I mean, as you can see from the video, I just did the ticking stripe, pretty much winged it. I sort of measured, Like I did the first one, winged it, and then I just sort of measured roughly what I did for the first one and tried to replicate it on the second one. So there you go, guys. That's the first pillow done. I'm pretty happy with that. I think if I did the next one, I'll probably make the ties a little bit longer and then double knot them. I mean, I don't think they're really going to come undone too much just sitting on my bed like that. But if it's going to be a pillow you're sort of using regularly, I would just probably make the tie bits a little bit longer and then just double knot.
So there you go, guys. There's the finished cushions. I am super happy with the way they've turned out, even though I did have a bit of a disaster with the writing. But at the end of the day, I think it looks all right. A little bit of freehand, a little bit of, you know, copying. But yeah, how easy are they? Like no sewing involved, no hot glue involved. Just, yeah, tie them all together and they're super easy. You can just slip them off to wash them in cold water so the permanent marker doesn't fade. But yeah, these will eventually go on my bed, but I just haven't got my Christmas bedding on quite yet. That will hopefully go on this weekend. And that's the other one there with just the stripes going down the middle. I do hope you check out everyone else's videos in the collab. If you like what you see, definitely subscribe to all their channels. They're the most beautiful people on YouTube and I love them all dearly. So I religiously watch every single one of their channels. So make sure you check them out and I'm sure you will love them as well. And if you have any questions or comments, please leave them below. And I will see you guys in my next video. Thanks for watching. So today I'm going to try and not say words with S, but a Christmas. Today I am super this Invisalign. I should have took them out. Oh God. Okay. I am super excited.
I'm just going to chalk the back of it and we're going to then just trace it on. And I'll just check before I go and do the whole lot that it's actually transferring. No, it's not. Might have to go over it with the pencil, I think. Okay, so for the words, I don't have a Cricut, but if you have one of those and they do that, this sort of thing, then go ahead and use that, Smarty Pants, but I don't have one. So I'm just going to basically cut out and make a stencil out of this. You know what? It's not going to work.